la mairie des Ouches et puis on représente bien sûr la vallée de Chamonix.
Good morning and welcome to live coverage from the UTMB. Today we are over in Switzerland and we're at the start of the OCC, so the race that is 55 kilometers running from Orsier and then running through the course of the UTMB all the way back to Chamonix. So we're covering a distance today of 55 kilometers and over 3,000 meters of elevation. Is that right, Randy?
I think that's right on. And this race was started in 2014. It's been running in this trail festival of races for its third year now this year. And though it is a shorter race, it has some very steep climbs. We're not going to see for the average runner the kind of time that you would think from a shorter race. It's a very difficult race, notwithstanding its distance.
Sure. I think we're expecting the fastest runner to complete the course today in about 5 hours. So the runners will be into Chamonix around about 1 o'clock. So we've got 1,200 runners on the start line of this particular race. And as you can see on the screen now, we just discovered this morning that Xavier Thévenard, two times winner of the UTMB, winner of the UTMB in 2016, is on the start line. So that guarantees it's going to be fast.
Yes, it's going to be fast. And there's no question that he will instantly, by joining the race, be someone to watch. Others who thought that this was the race that they're going to perform in and outperform others will be watching him and trying to stay with him. This is going to be more like a marathon race where runners are matching each other than the race we watched yesterday, the TDS. I'm looking at some statistics about this race. This race will have the oldest runner of the Festival of Races, a man 84 years old.
Good lad. So trail running is good for you. That's all we can say on that one. So, Switzerland finally gets a start in the UTMB. So for many years, the races either began in Chamonix or they began in Courmayeur. And as we know, the UTMB and the CCC always passes through Champs-Élysées and through into Switzerland. So finally, the Swiss said, we believe that we can also host the start of a race. And there we go, Dawa Sherpa, winner of UTMB way back in 2004. So, OCC is a short race, but it's still being kind of feted, if you like, by some stars of trail running. And so good to see him on the start line.
Sure. Though it's a shorter race, it covers the same ground, same kind of trails, same conditions, same steep climbs, same steep descents, same rocky terrain, and the same beautiful views.
Absolutely. And if you think of it a different way, you want to be part of the UTMB, but you're not necessarily sure that you have the ability or the desire to run 170 kilometers. So now you can do 55 kilometers on the course and you're part of the UTMB. You go there, I'm going to the UTMB. So yep, there's another 1,200 people that can be actually part of the event.
And that's how the race directors have formulated the races, so that there's this festival of races, not just one. And the runners compete only in one of the festival of races. And so there are runners who want to compete in all of them, and we will see the best runners in the OCC over the years.
So I think our colleague Clément was, I think, looked a little bit worried there that they were going to start, but no, I think we have 5 minutes before the start. I think it's this year. I'm wondering, there's a kind of running out of Orsier, and then very quickly, for those of you who've run either the CCC or the UTMB, they will go through what I call the magic forest. Feels like a never-ending forest as you do that climb up to Champs-Élysées. Certainly, if you're doing the longer race, it just feels like you never pop out at the top. But we'll have the cameras up in Champs-Élysées. Champs-Élysées, for me, is one place that time has stood still, and I say that in a really, really positive way. It's such a beautiful, calm, and wonderful place to be, and also the cake shop of Léon up there in Champs-Élysées.
So I'm looking at the faces of these runners. They look like they've a young group here at the front of the pack, and also very fit runners, people who are ready to put themselves out and leave nothing behind.
Si on peut lancer la musique officielle, s'il vous plaît. Laissez les coureurs rentrer dans leur bulle. On vous souhaite à tous une très très belle course. Eh bien, si on emploie la musique, c'est pas grave. Pour l'instant, on va demander au public de commencer à taper dans les mains pour faire du son. Allez, on tape, 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 on tape. Clap, 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 clap. Allez, on y va, on tape. Et même les coureurs peuvent taper dans les mains. Tape, 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 tape. Une minute.
It's a very narrow start, so I think the runners at the front, they're not clapping. They're thinking, how am I going to get through this without falling over and getting trampled?
Ouais, on accélère. Vous êtes magique.
Right, it looks like they're going to just push them through a big tunnel or a big funnel.
Ouais.
Yeah, those sticks. Those are kind of scary at the front, especially the front bit, but those guys will move quickly. Here we go.
30 seconds.
30 seconds. Yep, we need to move the guy with the phone. Or the girl. It's a girl, pink. Pink phone case. Excusez-moi.
Parti!
Go!
And the race has started.
Ha ha! Orcière Chamonix, on vous attend! Applaudissements! Encouragement!
To Chamonix in
et
one day.
Et on sourit, on lève les mains quand on passe sous l'arche. Des sourires! Des sourires! Et encore des sourires!
Here are the runners leaving Orsay, Switzerland, headed for Chamonix, France, in the third race that has now started of the UTMB Trail Festival. The runners of all these three races are now out on the course. There are racers from the PTL race, which started on Monday. There are runners from the TDS race that started yesterday morning. And now there are runners of the OCC race.
So we
what an organization.
Yeah, we're already going to be looking forward to seeing what's happening at the front of the race within 10 kilometers up at Champs-Pélag. So they're going to be quickly climbing. And once they kind of get free of this bottleneck, so we'll get a clear idea of that. I think for those of you joining who maybe are wondering what's happened overnight, we'll be shortly, once we've completed the start and waved everybody off, I think we're already going to give you a quick replay of what happened in the TDS as well, so you can stay tuned for that if you're looking for more information on TDS. We'll also have the camera at the finish line for the TDS runners who are coming in now. It's now 17 minutes past 8 here in the morning in Chamonix. So my quick calculations tell me that the TDS runners, they've been running on the course now for 26 hours and 17 minutes. And as we came across to the studio this morning, we saw them coming in. And we've all been to bed and we've had a bit of a sleep. So those guys look a little bit bedraggled, but so happy and so proud to be home.
Yeah, what a lot of enthusiasm here at the start of the OCC race. They know they get the chance to show off for the camera and enjoy the trail ahead. There's so many parts of this race. The narrow streets of the towns, the trails, the ups, the downs, the beauty, the distant mountains, the close-in beauty, the people, the languages, all of it make part of this race. And today, the heat might be a factor, though many of the racers will have had the chance to finish before the hottest day, moments of the day.
Yeah, we've been seeing yesterday with the TDS that looking at the numbers of runners coming through overnight, that they the heat definitely took its toll yesterday. So this is going to be another day of hydration is key, as well as eating. So shorter race, but 55K is still something that you need to make sure you're carrying the right equipment and that you're looking after yourself on the course. Have fun, guys. I wish I was out there with you.